Wait, David. Wait a minute. What do you mean you don't know? I pay you to know. It's your job. The money they're spending pays your fucking salary. You got it? Thank you. I'll find out how much. That's right. Good. And book me a flight. I gotta get there. I don't believe this, son of a bitch.
We declared that guardian.
Beautiful.
Ted, why is this happening?
Shh. Don't worry, Donna. Somehow, I'll take care of it.
Becoming harder and harder for me to distinguish what's real and what's imaginary. Why is my son trying to declare me insane in front of the world? What have I done to deserve this? And though Ted tries to shield me from my son, to protect me, I feel like I'm being held in prison. Who are these people who've come into my room and taken over my life? Why is this happening to me? Is life really worth living like this?
Okay, come on, Laurie. It's time for your facial.
My name is Mrs. Kittredge, and I don't want a facial. I just had a facial.
I would know whether or not you had a facial, wouldn't I?
I'm not making it up. She's trying to make you think that I'm losing my mind. I'm not insane.
No, ma'am.
And I'm not going anywhere.
Sarah made this appointment for you. Don't you remember?
Mr. Kittredge will be worried about me.
Look at you. You need a facial. You don't want your husband to start dating younger women, do you?
Monet.
Where's my husband? He's going to be so worried about
it. Her real name is Allison Ray. She isn't even a nurse. She's a con artist. She's even been arrested for burglary.
Come on.
Honda, somebody's been going through this town.
James. What the hell are you two doing?
Mr. Kittredge, I think Monet has been going to your things.
Damn it!
What's this?
An obituary.
Whose?
Monet Fletcher.
Her real name is Allison Ray.
You telling me she's not a nurse?
Yes, she's not.
Son of a bitch, this is a nightmare! First he's stealing from his mother, now he's trying to destroy her!
Don't you, Daddy, want some?
Huh? You're sick, you know that? You're sick. You belong in some home. Come up here. Bitch.
What are you going to do now, huh? Use the phone, huh? As soon as you let go of my head, I'm going to scratch your eyes out.
Get out.
Go on, go on. Come on.
Nurse. 319. Give me the police.
Excuse me?
Get me the police!
I'll see you soon, Dad. Say hello to your wife for me, would you? Don't touch me.
Well, that's that. Mother has been declared incompetent, and I'm a billionaire. I'm a billionaire. Holy shit. Can you imagine those old fools trying to hide $10 million from me? It was easy thanks to you.
We had a lot at stake, didn't we?
Oh, God, yes, little sister. We had a lot at stake.
In con.
I figured, what the hell? I might as well stay for a while. How much is a room?
Have you made the booking?
Well, there is nothing for you, sir.
But no room?
No room at all, and you know it's quite difficult to find a room in Cannes. All hotels are full. Perhaps you can sleep, the street and the railway station, but there is no room left in Cannes.
Je suis désolé, nous avons plus de chambres. Il faut réserver un mois à l'avance. Minimum, un mois à l'avance. Minimum. Désolé, monsieur. La prochaine année, vous réservez. Bye.
There's nothing like sleeping on the beach at night. Except maybe waking up on the beach in the morning.
And he said that he wanted to prove something to this town. That it could be done. And he wanted me to be the guy to prove it.
First, take those things off. The glasses. Remember, the less you say, the better. Creates an air of mystery. It gives you an intellectual aura. You go to a party or anywhere, you meet someone, pay them a compliment right away, and listen to them talk about themselves. Makes you look like a genius. Always have a purpose when you're walking up the sound with some authority. Look at a few people, you wave hi as they go by, so long, see you later, whatever. It's like, that's it.
You know, it's not me, man. I'm a good guy. I mean, sure, the story's got its little things, you know, that maybe I gotta iron out.
You know what, it's not a spiritual story. It's bullshit.
You know what, I don't feel connected, really, to the earth at this point.
I don't either.
Go.
What's going on?
Go.
Hey.
Go away,
go.
Man.
Go.
You know?
Am I being too loud?
We're Psy. Maybe you made a deal with Psy.
I could talk slower.
I don't know you.
You're great, you're
good. Hey, come on. Hey, already, you know.
Fucking made a deal with Psy, I thought. I don't even know who this jerk off is, and then it's all over the Croisette. It's
what
like
a fucking
Dennis
shirt,
Hopper.
The shirt.
Who was I kidding? I wasn't a writer. I wasn't a movie mogul. I wasn't a producer. Well, let's face it, I was a nobody without Psy. The festival was over. And so was that brief, glorious career of the famous screenwriter Frank Rhino. Just another face in the crowd. Another pair of shoes on the tarmac.
person's last words are actually the first words they say in the afterlife. On her deathbed, my close friend said she thought she was going to another galaxy after her death. She said she had a recurring vision. She was in a classroom with everyone dressed in white in a class about spirituality. Then some months after her death, I had a spontaneous out-of-body experience where she guided me to that place, her galaxy. I felt I had actually been to visit my dear friend in her new part of the universe. Was it a dream? Or did I really find her? And how could I go back on my own? I began studying near-death experiences, past life memories, reincarnation. Prevailing science tells us we make these things up. Dr. Michael Newton is a hypnotherapist who spent his life studying patients under deep hypnosis. He claimed with sufficient trance depth, clients could take him to areas of the subconscious that remembered not only past lives, but a life between lives, where they say we all journey after death. 7,000 patients who had never met saying basically the same things under deep hypnosis about the afterlife. I was determined to go on this journey and see if what they were saying could possibly be.